Good morning, everyone. Today we will be discussing about economic load dispatch when transmission losses are included. In the last class, we have seen the solution for economic load dispatch problem, excluding the transmission losses. So today, we will include these transmission losses and we will solve this problem of economic load dispatch. Coming to the aim of economic load dispatch problem, our target is very simple. We do have a single target of minimization of total cost of generation. Minimization of total cost of generation, or in other words, minimization of total fuel inputs, or total fuel cost. Any of these terms, any of these terms can be used, but the aim remains the same. Your target is minimization of total cost of generation, which also includes minimization of total fuel input, which is nothing but you are minimizing your total fuel cost. Subjective to subjective to the equality constraint, subjected to the equality constraint, which is this is your equality constraint. In the last class, in the last topic, we have ignored PL. We have used only this equation. Sum of generations is equal to your demand. Now we are including sum of generations must be equal to your demand and losses. PD indicates a demand, whereas PL indicates a losses of your system. I'll write down here very clearly where PGI is the generation at ith plant in megawatts. PD is a demand of the system. And PL is the total transmission losses of the system. That is the total transmission losses of the system. Guys, one thing I would like to mention here. Now, considering power demand and PL, most important thing is demand does not depend upon generation. Demand does not depend upon the generation. Demand is an independent element in this ELD problem. Try to remember that. Demand is an independent element. So that's why it is considered as independent variable. Whereas PL depends on generation. PL depends upon generation. I will give a small example. Now let us suppose I do have two generating plants. I do have two generating plants here. Now let us suppose, you see, if this is a transmission line which takes off 10% of power transfer. If let us suppose if transmission line absorbs 10% of the power which is being transferred over the system, which means that it is resulting in a 10% loss. Now, I do have two generators which I am trying to employ for meeting my demand of 100 megawatts. This is my demand, PD. I can employ both generators or I can employ only one generator at a time. Now we will see KCA. If I do employ only generator one, if I employ only generator one, see, the power will be flowing from here to here. If I employ only generator one, which means PG1 is equal to 100, and PG2 is equal to 0, which means that here I will be generating the power 100 megawatts, and here the power will be like this. See, since the power is moving on this transmission line, it results in 10% loss. So what is my power loss? 10% of the total 100 megawatts power, which is being transmitted here. So my PL is 10 megawatts. Is it? Now, case number B, if I use only G2, this generator 1 is not generating any power, only G2 is generating power, then the same power will be supplied here to the load. See now, the path is like this. There is no need of my transmission line. Since there is no need of any transmission line, what is my power loss? My power loss is here. PG1 is 0, PG2 is 100. So my PL is 0 because I have not employed any transmission line. See, my total transmission losses. Here in this case, when PG1 is generating, I do have a loss. Here, I don't have any loss. Which means that the losses are going to depend upon the generation of your system. Generation of the units of your system. So that's why I am mentioning here, PL depends upon PG. Okay. Whereas PD is independent of PG. Okay. So try to remember this one. We will derive an appropriate equation for PL in terms of PG in the next class. But as of now, just remember that PL depends upon PG. Okay. Now, having said this, our target is minimization of total cost of generation subjected to the constraint where the total generation is equal to demand plus losses. Demand is independent of generation, whereas loss is dependent on the generations. I hope you have understood. Now, let's get back to our problem. Our target is optimal load dispatch or economic load dispatch or optimal load scheduling. Whatever may be the term, all relate the same. Optimal load dispatch, including the transmission losses. Including transmission losses. So that is our target, which has been written there directly. So now, let's write the mathematical expression of our problem. Our target is minimizing the total costs. CT represents a total cost of generation, which is equal to the sum of costs at all the plants. See, this is the total cost. This is the sum of the costs at all the generating plants, subjected to the constraint. Or if you want to mention only fuel consumption, this is minimizing total cost. Or you can go with only minimization of just only fuel input. Both represent the same. If I reduce the fuel input, then automatically cost will be reduced. If I reduce the cost, means automatically my fuel input has been reduced. Because I am confining myself only to thermal plants. I told you on the first class itself, this is being done on thermal plants only. So this is my problem, this is my constraint. So using Lagrange multiplier, using Lagrangian multiplier now, the auxiliary function is given by auxiliary function C is equal to Ct. This is Ct. That is lambda into this is my auxiliary function. Now, which can also be written as target is minimization of C. For obtaining minimum value of C, what I am supposed to do, DC by, because the only variable term in this entire equation is generations, because I am more concerned about the generations. So that's why I am differentiating it with respect to the generations. If I differentiate it, CI is already dependent on generation, power generation. I will be neglected here, sigma. So this will become dCi by dPgi. This lambda, as already I told you, demand is independent of generation, zero. But whereas this is dependent on generation, minus, this will become one. Now if carefully see, if I subject everything, lambda is equal to this is your equation. you understand this entire derivation? Lambda is equal to dci by dpgi by 1 minus dpl into, sorry, dpl by dpgi. Now, what is lambda? Lambda is basically a constant. Now, I, it varies from 1 to L. Now, in the earlier case, without losses, what we have obtained the condition? The condition for economic load dispatch was just, this was our condition for ELD without losses. Now, if we consider the losses, what is the expression change? So additionally, I have got some term in the denominator. Earlier, I have neglected DPL, so denominator used to be 1. But since I am considering DPL now, this has become a significant term. Okay. Now, in this term, you know, DCI by DPGI, what it is called as? It is called as incremental cost of I plant. Isn't it? We have represented as IC, isn't it? Now, there is another term, if you carefully see, it is DPL by DPGI. This is called as ITL, incremental transmission loss. Now, if I represent it in the short forms, ICI by 1 minus ITL, I is equal to lambda. So if I expand it for n terms, so how it will be looking like? IC1 by 1 minus ITL1 is equal to IC2 by 1 minus ITL2 minus is equal to IC3 by 1 minus ITL3, like that. Earlier, what we had only these things, IC1, IC2, and IC3. Now, what we are getting? We are getting a very large equation. And this particular term, I'll write down. In most of your textbooks and in your research articles, this term, 1 by 1 minus ITL, is referred as penalty factor. Shortly represented as PF. So if I employ here, see now, IC1 into penalty factor 1 is equal to IC2 into penalty factor 2, that is equal to IC3 into penalty factor 3, like this. Okay. So what do you mean by penalty factor? It is the equal to 1 minus 1 by ITL. Where what is ITL? ITL is incremental transmission loss, which is equal to dou PL by dou PGI. Okay. Now, this particular equation, is called as condition. This is called as condition for optimal load dispatch with losses. Condition for optimal load dispatch with losses. So If I write it in a sentence format, if I write it in a sentence format, can anybody say, shall I erase this one?
So, penning down the condition
in a sentence format. For economic load dispatch, economic load dispatch including losses, the product of incremental costs and the penalty factor of each plant must be same. So for each plant, whatever the incremental cost is there and the penalty factor is there, the product of incremental cost and the penalty factor, this must remain constant for all of the plants. This must be the same. The products must be the same. Now, if penalty factor, now I will show you. If penalty factor is 1, then what is ideal? Ideal is equal to 0. Then vice versa, whatever it may be. Isn't it? I'll show you. Because PF is equal to 1 minus ITL inverse, right? If ITL is equal to 0, penalty factor is equal to 1. If ITL is equal to 1, then penalty factor is infinite. Vice versa. If penalty factor is equal to 1, which means that ITL is equal to 0. Penalty factor is equal to infinite, means ITL is equal to 1. Okay, so what we have learned for today, for economic load dispatch including losses, the product of incremental cost and penalty factors at all the plants must be the same. This is our condition. Okay.